In terms of consequences for politicians who were in favor of the insurrection on January 6th, whether the storming the building and pooping on the floor kind, or the trying to overturn the vote kind, which the politicians themselves took part in, there haven't been many consequences. But one was that, at least briefly, corporations said that they would not be donating money to them. So right afterward, about 170 different companies announced they were suspending donations from their corporate PACs to the 147 different Republicans who voted to overturn the election results, or that they weren't going to give to anyone, which is like the most ridiculous both sidesing ever. Now, on April 15th, there was the first major campaign finance deadline since that pledge. They had to provide information about what donations they've given. And those findings, according to Judd Legum at Popular Info, reveal that most corporations that said they were suspending their donations have actually kept their word. So that is, I think, an important finding coming out of this, is that a lot of them so far have kept their word. Now, bear in mind, there haven't been a lot of elections. We'll see what happens when the midterms come. But that said, some very much are already giving again. And Axios put together this visualization of the number of donations and the amount of donations that different companies have been doing. And there's a lot of big ones: AT&T, Cigna, Koch Industries, some of those others I don't know, but Deere and Company, I think I know that one. But Toyota is actually leading the pack, almost lapping the pack there, way beyond the others. And that's interesting. So what's going on there? Well, Toyota said soon after the insurrection, given recent events and the horrific attack on the US Capitol, we are assessing our future PAC criteria. But it only took a few weeks for them to start donating, not just to politicians, but to the politicians that voted against certifying the Electoral College. They ended up, so far, by the time of that first FEC filing date, they donated to 40 different Republicans, $62,000 overall. And not just ones that voted for it. Some, like Congressman Andy Biggs, were like the most out in front in saying that the election was fake, it needs to be overturned, and they are financially supporting him once again. Now, we'll have their response to this information coming out, but Francesca, what are your thoughts?
I'm gonna go burn my Prius. I think that's what the woke thing to do is, is to light it on fire. And drive it into the ocean.
I mean, those might cancel out a bit, but I think it'll be destroyed. I get your point. Yeah, it's disappointing.
It's very disappointing, but it also makes absolute sense that these corporations, I don't know why Toyota more, you know, are we afraid of whatever we're afraid of? We're afraid that, like, we might raise the minimum wage, or we afraid there's gonna be corporate taxes, or we afraid, any of the number of things that they, it's mostly just money. It's mostly that. It's mostly just trying to get one over on workers and making sure they don't pay any more taxes. That's pretty much it. Yeah. You know, and so yes, in theory, I mean, this is the same thing with, you know, the BLM performative, you know, corporate stuff that was happening a year ago. Like, we understand that their bottom line is their bottom line, and that they're not gonna do anything that would threaten that. You know, companies are not going to come out against prison labor, even though, you know, even though that would be, when it comes to criminal justice reform, a thing you should do. But they won't, because they make money off of it.
Yeah. I mean, look, so I'm looking, we have these donations, and great work, Axios talking about it, Judd Legum did. I'm also just looking at their overall donations, and they do the sort of thing that you would expect. So they maxed out $10,000 corporate donation to Hakeem Jeffries, Democrat, and $10,000 to Daryl Issa, a Republican. Richard Neal, Democrat, maxed out. Rodney Davis, Republican, maxed out. They max out to basically all of them, so that no matter who wins, they get what they want. Which, by the way, is there any better, just like devastation of the argument that no. These donations aren't a bribe. A bribe changes the behavior. All we're doing is rewarding politicians who already agree with us. We like their position that they already genuinely have, and we're financially benefiting it. For Daryl Issa and Hakeem Jeffries, Marjorie Greene and Ilhan Omar, we're just donating to everybody. I don't know if they donated to those two.
No.
We're just donating to everybody. So it is clearly intended to be a bribe. And Toyota is only one of literally thousands of companies that do this. But to donate so readily, like you have to donate to Andy Biggs a month after the insurrection. You have to do that.
Andy Biggs helped plan the Stop the Steal rally. We don't talk about this enough. Mo Brooks, Andy Biggs, Paul Gosar, these are planners of the Stop the Steal rally, currently still sitting congressmen. So yeah, did you have to donate to the planners of the rally? You know, the insurrectionists specifically?
Apparently.
Hakeem Jeffries makes total sense though, John. I mean, look, he just announced that he was creating some sort of like anti-squad pack or some initiative in the Democratic caucus to basically stop the growth of the squad and stop the growth of Justice Democrats. Yeah. So somebody's scared.
Yeah, well, let's give them a chance to respond.
Sure.
So let's see. They said, "We do not believe it is appropriate to judge members of Congress solely based on their votes on the electoral certification." Okay, so I don't necessarily think that we all need to be single issue voters or D voters. But that said, if you were gonna choose one thing, seems like an okay one. I mean, they don't think elections should count. That's fairly fundamental, I think, in a democracy, whether you think elections should count or whether, you know, if we have enough power and we could just overwhelm them, we get to say no. But no, apparently that is by itself not enough. Now, they did say, based on our thorough review, oh, I bet it was so thorough, we decided against giving to some members who, through their statements and actions, undermine the legitimacy of our elections and institutions. And to that, I would say, you can go F yourself, Toyota, because you gave to Andy Biggs. So your review wasn't that thorough, okay? Now, they didn't respond to a follow-up from Axios about the specific threshold for statements that cross the line. And the reason for that might be because they were okay with guys like who are literally doing Stop the Steal stuff, planning, as Francesca said, the actual rally. So no, there's no threshold. It's not some sort of objective or even somewhat squishy standard. They're giving to the politicians they want to. That's what it is. They've limited some that they don't think are necessary. But no matter how bad an anti-democratic a politician is, if they think that they need him to have their back, they're gonna support him. That is clearly what Toyota is doing here.
Yeah. Look, again, the bottom line, it's their bottom. They know who's gonna protect them. They know that when so-called socialism comes, which it's not, it's just asking you to pay your fair share and for people to like make a living. That these are the Congress people who will not at all. And it's so funny because it's not that much money. I mean, that's the thing. You're like 50,000. It doesn't speak to whether they can. They could totally bribe with more. But our politicians suck so hard that it doesn't take that much money to bribe them. All you need is 50,000. You could do $3,000, $5,000.
Yeah. Yeah, like. And it really is such an indictment of who they are. Like theoretically, everyone has a price that they would sell out, you know, for. Like, sure. You know,
$600,000 right here.
$50 million, $600,000 specifically. She knows exactly what it is.
Good like, health care. Like,
exactly. It might take $600,000 for that. if it's $10,000, man, you didn't give a damn about any of this. Like that is, and they're all rich. They're all already rich. So man, you just have no values whatsoever. Hold out for like a million, come on. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.